Hi, welcome to InspireUI. In this video, we will show you how to install FluxStore into any devices running on macOS. This tutorial will be covering four main parts. First, we're going to go through all of the requirements to install FluxStore. Second, we're going to run a Flutter test drive in order to make sure that our IDEs and Flutter have been installed correctly. Third, we're going to customize the environment file to make FluxStore compatible with your website. Last but not least, we're going to run a FluxStore project. Okay, waiting no more, let's get started. In order to run FluxStore, you have to have either Android Studio or Visual Studio Code installed in your machine. Besides, make sure that your FluxStore is running with latest stable version. Moreover, make sure that you have already upgraded your FluxStore into 2.0, which you can get from Canyon. If you got any problem with the first two requirements, please check out our support document guide in the general section to getting started. You can read the handwritten guide here, or you can watch the whole video or tutorial. If everything is okay now, it's time to run a Flutter test drive. In order to run this, open your Android Studio. Now choose Create a new Flutter project. Click on Flutter application. Enter your project name. Make sure that Flutter SDK path has been pointed to where you install Flutter. Update your project location and description. Click Next. You can enter your package name here, or you can leave it as default. Then click Finish. Android Studio will need a little time to open your project. All of the modifications will be taken place at the main.dart file here. Now let's check our Flutter and Dart plugin. Click on plugins. Make sure that Dart plugin and Flutter plugin have been installed successfully. And with latest version, of course. Now click on languages and frameworks. Make sure that your Dart SDK path and Flutter SDK path have been pointed to where you install Flutter. Also, make sure that Dart support has been enabled for your project. Now, the next thing we want to do is switch to stable general. You can do it by typing Flutter general stable. Now run Flutter upgrade to make sure that you are on the latest build of this general. Things may take a while. When it's done, run Flutter Doctor to review our settings again. There is no issue file. We are free to go now. Now open your iOS simulator and run your project. When we successfully run it, Flutter demo homepage will appear. Now it's time to test Flutter Inspector and Flutter hot reload features. Click on the target button and click on this tag to locate widgets. Now let's try to change the content of the widget. I'm going to change pushed to clicked. And when we click on hot reload, the content of the widget is supposed to be changed. Yeah, it changed. Now let's prepare for step 3 by opening your Android Studio. Then click on open an existing project and point its location to our FluxStore 2.0, which you can get from Code Canyon. First of all, let's review all of our settings. Click on Android Studio Preferences. Make sure that Dark and Flutter has been installed. Besides, make sure that Flutter International plugin have been installed to support multiple languages. Make sure that your Dark SDK path is valid and Dark support is enabled for your object. Also, make sure that Flutter SDK path is also valid. We have done with the first two steps. Now it's time to customize the environment file to make FluxStore compatible with the website. First thing first, open your environment file, which is env.dart file located under the lib folder. Now we need to fill all our server config settings. If you use FluxStore 2.9 or earlier, you can refer to the config.dart file to fill all of its values. For block session, you can remove it if you use the same URL. Or for the forget password session, you can either remove it or leave it blank to use its native string. Also, make sure that the app config setting is pointing to the config.json file regarding your main language. You can find and delete all the config.json file for all languages under the config folder. Because we use English as our main language, config_en.json file will be our main configuration. And this is how it looks like. Now click on run your project. Things may take a while. When it successfully runs, you will see how your app looks like, depending on the configurations and settings we have defined. Everything looks kind of good now, except there is a typo issue. We use Vietnamese instead of English. Now let's try to fix it. Go to the config.json file, locate its widget under the vertical layout. Now change its name to the English one. And then hot restart your app. Let's see. Yeah, we have successfully fixed it. Everything is perfect now. So, in the world, we have shown you how to install FluxStore into macOS. When installing, if you got any problems, feel free to check out our common Flutter installing issues. We will keep updating your issues as well as the solution here. If none of your issues can be found, feel free to leave a support ticket. The technical team will give you a hand on solving this. So this is the end of the tutorial. Good luck with your installation and thank you for watching.